Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor here at the Joint Ectrums Actrums meeting in Boston 2014. And I'm so happy to be joined by one of the authors of one of the presentations that we heard several days ago. So, Samuel Hughes, you are a research coordinator at UT Southwestern. Tell me about the research that you presented.
So what I presented this week while we were here was just very simple data from our pediatric population at UT Southwestern and Children's Medical Center, focusing on some of our eye data from OCT, ocular coherence tomography testing, looking at retinal nerve fiber layers and their thinning compared to patients' visual acuity. So both high and low contrast. And basically what we focused on was this cohort of children who seemed to have very damaged optic nerves in the context of demyelinating disease, but retained visual acuity, both high and low contrast. So they can see normally, but according to everything we understand about the way the optic nerve works, they shouldn't be able to see in any way normally. And so that's this phenomenon that we've seen in our group that has not been reported in the literature anywhere, but is a very interesting finding.
Why do you think that's happening? Why do you think that people's nerves are too thin, but yet they're seeing well?
So there's that begs a lot of questions, and that's one thing that's kind of, I guess, interesting and difficult about this is that there are a lot of questions that this asks. So part of this is looking at the children in particular. Their brains are still developing. There might be something that is happening that, based on the damage that's happening to the optic nerve, is triggering some kind of restructuring of the visual cortex that allows them to recover functionally. We don't understand how this works at this point, and there's going to be a lot more testing that needs to be done to really better pinpoint what it is that could be allowing this to happen. But if we can do that, that has major implications, not just on multiple sclerosis and demyelinating disease, but just in brain plasticity and developmental neural networking.
Research is important for several reasons. Sometimes you think about research as just looking for a specific treatment, but other types of research tells us more about the human body, and we find out things we didn't know, and it helps give us clues to maybe treatments that we can do in the future. How can we take other people who have thinner nerves but make them see better or walk better or do other things better? I want to thank you so much for the work that you do, and I want to thank you for joining us at home.